You can pick one up with a Quetzal. Oh, that's so cool, man. What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things on the Ark Survival Evolved Hooping Evolved server. Hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. There's been an explosion. I'm dancing for the explosion of Ark stuff and things going on the server and in the community. The new baby dinos have dropped. Let's check our egg really quick. We just got to keep looking at it. Are you incubating? Okay, let's go back. So there's been an explosion of stuff and things. We got the new, is it the Mosasaurus? One of those things. And then we've got the new dino babies. And yeah, stuff and things have been happening. So I'm glad you guys are back hanging out. Thank you very much for all your likes and support on the previous videos. It's been amazing. It continues to be so, and it's all because of you guys. Make sure if you guys like the video, please don't forget to smash the like button to show your support. And if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe for more Ark stuff and things. All right, so in the previous episode, we made Weetooth, and Weetooth died. So when I got done doing the video last night, it was about 1 o'clock in the morning, and Weetooth was eating a ridiculous amount of food. Got done making the video, stayed up a little bit, making sure that we had some food for him. And then eventually after a little bit, I was like, you know what? It's just too late. I gotta go to sleep. So, Drax said he would stay and watch him for a little bit. He set up another feeding trough, and he actually set up, let's check our egg really quickly. Incubating. Okay. What's the temperature? 72. Can we turn off one fire? Too cold. Incubating. All right. So, Drax set up a second feeding trough, and we filled these. He filled them, actually, pardon me, all completely with meat. And then he said he stayed up for another couple of hours watching it, and eventually he had to go to sleep as well. And what ended up going on was the baby died. So, So it died, and there was a couple other people, I think, some threads in the community and the Ark discussion saying that some stuff and things just kind of weren't working right. And the devs listened to us. Baby food consumption rate decreased by 60%. And the maturation speed has been doubled. So an effective 80% overall food reduction in order to get stuff and things to work. So with those changes, I'm hoping today we could get a new baby Rex ready to rock and roll. So I got this egg. I got him back over here. I'm watching the temperature. At night, I'm picking the egg up. It just gets too cold to incubate. So that's no problems there. I've been hanging out with Drax, and he's got this little guy, Juvenile Raptor, that's actually in a higher maturation process. At this point. So he's growing a little one of these guys. And look how cute he looks. He's so cute. He's just like a little buddy. But really some interesting stuff, guys, because now, you know, if you have a couple 120th level T-Rexes on your server, for instance, you don't have to go out and find another 120th level T-Rex ever again. You can just mate them. And then you'll get, you know what I mean? As long as they're, you got good tames on them, hopefully perfect tames on them, you'll get like perfect tame juveniles, I think, which is really, really cool. Some other changes they did make now is that baby dinos in the baby phase, which is less than 10% matured, will no longer consume food from feeding troughs. So the initial portion of your baby adventure has to be feeding them manually, feeding them with your hands. And that way they can imprint on you and become yours forever and ever and ever. So we're going to go ahead and incubate this egg. When it's ready to hatch, I'm going to bring you back. I showed you guys kind of the mating stuff and things, and we did a bit of this egg hatching yesterday. But today I want to take a look at the maturation process and how that's all going to work. So that's what we're going to do. I'm really excited. So I'm going to sit here and watch this egg, make sure it doesn't get cold. And I'll BRBs, peeps. And we're back, and he hatched. We got an imprint. I missed the hatching. I'm sorry, guys. We got an imprint. We're going to call him Y-Tooth again. And we got a little buddy. Oh, we got to get meat. Crap, 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 crap. Oh, crap, 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 crap. Give me the meat. 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 Crap, crap, crap. Get out of the way. Get out of the way. All right. Eat. How much is he going to eat? Oh. Okay, so you can see it's really fast. It's not quite as fast as it was. But his health's sticking around 600. It looks like his statistics... Oh, crap. I have to go back and look at the other video to see if there's a difference in the base stats. And it looks like his color is pretty similar. So he's not going to look at Zildjian. Zildjian's over here, man. He's just creeping up on it. Looks like he's floating. But it looks like, oh, wait. 17, 16. Oh, they're putting more meat on. Oh, can you put more? Oh, I thought. Oh, weird. So last night, I think it was that it only had one inventory slot. But now it looks like he can fill it up a little bit more. Now, you have to hand feed him. At this point, we could actually put this fire out, too. You have to hand feed him until he gets to a point where he's at 10% maturation. So that probably is going to take a little bit of time. But right now, this is not too bad. It's manageable. I can't get meat. Oh, there we go. Oh, this is weird. It won't put in like full stacks? Huh. That's kind of neat. I'm wondering why I can't get. Oh, there it can hold more. So it looks like as it matures, it gets to a point where it can hold more and more food. And it's not like based on its weight. It just must be based on its maturation stuff and things. So you can see it's going to take a while for us to get him to 10%. Now, every time he levels up or goes through like a growth stage, I do believe, he will begin to wander. So, all right, let's see if we can pull him over here. Come on, Y-Tooth. Let's get out. Come on, hang out with me, man. Is he just stuck again? Crap. No, there he goes. He's just kind of slow. He's not a super fast thinker. All right. He's just a baby. He just has a baby brain. Come on, Y-Tooth. Come over here, buddy. All right. All right. So now we got him out. All right. There we go. So what I want to do is try to get him over here by Bluetooth. Because we did find out. All right. There he goes. So what we can do now. All right. Stop. We can get him on the follow, and then now what should happen is even though he goes through a wander or goes on to wandering every time he goes through a growth stage, now he won't. Like, oh, see, now we can fit even more meat on him. Oh, that's crazy cool. But now he won't wander. And that's important, you know what I mean? You put all the time into these guys. You put all the time into growing them, growing the egg, getting the guys to mate, getting the egg to grow, then incubating the egg. You know, you don't want him to wander off and get killed by something straight away. So you can build a pen for him like I did in the last episode, but Drax is telling me that this wandering or this following technique works as well. So that's what we're going to do. So he's doing his thing. He's so cute. He's just hanging out. We're going to grow him. And I guess we'll just wait for the next stage. Now, this is going to take a long time, guys. It is going to be a long, long time. So I'm just going to kind of wait around, make sure he's fed, and I'll come back at the different growth stages to kind of show you what's going on. So, oh, so excited. Today we're going to, I hope we can get a full grown one for this episode. We shall see. But I'll BRB's peeps. And we're back and we've got a juvenile Y-Tooth. He's leveling up a little bit. Oh, wait. Did his level go down? 158? I can't remember now. I got to look back at the video. But one of the things, I was looking at the weight here and the weight here and kind of trying to figure out why I couldn't put more items in his inventory. And you can see right up top there, it actually shows that this weight, I don't know why it doesn't also mirror it here. But that's cool. Right here, you can see the weight is growing. So that's why initially I wasn't able to put more than a few pieces of meat on him at once. But now it's getting up there. We've got our adolescent, you can see, or juvenile, pardon me. You can see juvenile Y-Tooth right there. Now over here, Drax's guy, you can see it's an adolescent. And his has actually had some color changes happen where like he had like whitish feathers before. And now he's kind of changing his color a little bit. And he actually looks, I don't know, that's fairly large. I wish we had another raptor to put next to it so we could see. Obviously, the T-Rex is not getting anywhere near what the size would be for a T-Rex, but he's getting pretty big. He's getting pretty big. Let's take a look here. Yeah, we'll have to see. He's about up to my shoulder right now, so we'll use that as a reference point for when he gets bigger. But then, yeah, so over here, we got our guy. It's been, like I said, a little bit of time. He's rated about, I don't know what that would be, maybe 10%. Is he still eating food off of himself, or did he start eating it off of? Yeah, he's at 10% now. So he's not eating food off of his inventory anymore. He's eating it off of the, or out of the feeding trough now. So we're good to go with that. This is really cool. Like, it's kind of, you know, just sitting around doing stuff and things, like when you're doing a tame or anything like that. But it is neat to see him grow and see stuff and things happen. And it does feel good to know that I don't really have to necessarily worry about him so much with feeding him. Now we can do the trough and he'll just absorb the food through there and we don't really have to be like super concerned. I'm stuck. We don't have to be super concerned that he's going to die. But let's see, how much food do we got? We got a little bit in there. open. We got a ton. So we We still have a ton of food. And I'm just going to sit here and we're going to wait till we get an adolescent Y-tooth. And we're back conducting a little bit of experiment. We tried to pick these guys up. I was wondering, you know what? Might as well move him over to my base. Now that he's a juvenile, maybe I could like get some metal and get some stuff and things done while I was waiting. So Drax tried to pick him up with Archangel and we couldn't. So I'm going to try to pick him up with Zul'jin's Quetz. Oh, I got him. I do have him. Oh, man. So you can pick one up with a Quetzal. Oh, that's so cool, man. So as long as he's full of food, we should be able to go ahead and move him. And yeah, we can set him over at the base and get him set up over there. So I'll tell you what, I'm going to grab a little bit more food. I'm going to put some food on him. And then actually, before I go over to the base, well, he's not eating that much. I guess what I wanted to do is maybe go to my base first and make sure I have a stockpile of meat ready. But this should probably last him like a good long time, long enough for me to go out and get meat and not have it be a problem. So I think we're going to move him, peeps. This is going to be rad. And we're back. We're going to drop him off over by, I think the Stego's right here. All right, there he's down. We'll land. He's just going to sit. Let me take a look here really quickly. Let's get you and you. And then, do you have the saddle on you? They're, one of these guys, I think, has the Stego saddle on them. I probably pulled it off. All right, they're like that. Let's pull these guys over here a little bit. Where'd he go? All right, there he is. Juvenile Y-tooth. Come over here like a raid, like a so. All right, unfollow. Let's go ahead and get on this Stego. And then we will hit follow. So now Y-tooth will come over here. Let's take a look at his food. Okay, so he's still doing good on food. So what I'm going to do now is real quick, I'm going to go out on probably Toad. I'm just going to go around in the area here and just get a ton of meat ready to rock and roll. Get a bunch of it all squirted onto the feeding trough I have over there. Then I'll have to run the Quetzal back over to Poop City. And we should be good to go to grow our T-Rex here at our new base. All right, that's really cool. BRBs, peeps. And we're back with our juvenile Y-tooth doing stuff and things. Come over here, buddy. Show the peeps what you look like. So we'll just go ahead and we actually just had an RG come in here. Are you going to just stay right over here? All right. We just had an RG come in the area and thankfully I had Toad over here. So he took it out pretty quick. I don't think it attacked Y-tooth. I think it was good to go. But he's at the juvenile stage, which is the same stage he was at before. He looks so cute, but look, he is pretty big. Look at that. I wish you could keep him as like a toy. I want a toy guy that's only this big. I don't want to grow him all the way up. But now you can see he's up to 300 and something, 332, 333 weight. His health is slowly growing. So he's up to about 3,000 health now, which is definitely not bad. I mean, you know, he's like, you could possibly take him out and do stuff with him almost. I mean, I wouldn't risk it, especially when he's maturing. Like, it's been a long time I've been waiting. But one of the things I can tell you is that you guys, if out there who are going to do this, especially with the T-Rex, be prepared to make meat. I decided I wanted to bring him back so that I could go up to the Metal Mountain right across the way. This guy right here and harvest that. So I went up there and I harvested the metal. I brought some back over to hardware, about half of it. I went back up, harvested the rest. It probably took me 10, 12 minutes. Came back down, put the rest onto hardware, got it smelting up, came down here. Now, before I left to do that, I had filled this feeding trough. And when I came back, it was empty. I mean, he eats through meat so fast, it blows my mind. So you got to make sure you have a big carno or something that can go around, some sort of a carnivorous dinosaur that can go around and get meat for you, because these guys, especially the Rexes, I'm sure it's different for everybody. And I think that Drax was saying that the Raptors are maturing a lot faster and a little bit easier. But you definitely got to make sure that these guys are meated up. So you can see the maturation progress. We're not even at halfway yet. It's been a while of just hanging out doing stuff and things. But I'm cool. We're cool. I want to see him get full grown. And then we're going to take him and level him up and have some fun. So probably paint him, make a saddle, all sorts of stuff like that too. So, but yeah, wanted to stop and give you guys the update. I'm going to continue to mate. And I'll be Herbie's peeps. And we're back, and we have an adolescent. And I think he looks the same. I don't think he changed at all. I don't think he changed even a little bit. He's kissing me. Oh, he's nuzzling me. So, I want to show you guys the different stages and stuff and things. So I figured I'd let you know. He's got we're an adolescent now. It's been a little bit longer. I've been out gathering stuff and things, just getting rocks and stuff like that. The maturation progress bar is about halfway. And it's taking quite a while, but it's going to be worth it. What's up, White Tooth? But he's an adolescent and continues to eat like a horse. This one does. I've been going out and getting some meat here and there. I've got plenty. Like, this doesn't seem to be a problem. 3, 4, except counting and talking at the same time. Nailed it. So it doesn't seem to be a problem to keep him up. But yeah, figured I'd just bring it back and show you that the adolescent stage is here. And it doesn't seem to be that much different from the juvenile stage. But it is the thing that happened, peeps. BRBs. And we're back. And I don't think these guys grow, like, in stages as much as they just grow, like, all the time. This is Y-Tooth, and he's still in the adolescent stage. And I did this angle right here a couple times so you could see. Before, he was kind of, you know, his chin was more down where my head was. And now he's got a lot bigger. He's still in the adolescent phase. I wanted to bring you guys over just again because it's been taking so long. I missed you guys. I've been bored just hanging out here. But I figure what we do maybe is bring Bluetooth over just to get a size comparison. Let me see if we can angle this really nicely. Of course not. Ugh, his leg is broken. All right, here we go. Let's just get him kind of over in the same spot-ish. There we go. So we can kind of see a size comparison. And you can see they're not quite the same size. The adolescent is definitely a little bit smaller, but he's definitely also like slowly increasing in size as the maturation progress bar nears completion. We're almost there. I have got to say 20, 40, 60, 81, 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, 1,000, 1,200 meat. I'm going to take a wild guess and say he's probably eaten through this three times. Which I just find to be crazy. It's cool. Like, I'm able to get it. I'm able to do this. But it's been over 3,000 meat for sure, guys. Like, just an insane amount. And I've only had to really go out. It hasn't been a big deal in order to get it. I've only had to go out 3, 4, 5, probably, I think, 3 times to get meat. So not really that big of a deal. But, yeah, we're still on the road. Just thought I'd give you the progress update. Guys, get so big. You know what? We got to find out right now, actually. Let's go up here really quickly. And I wonder, can you paint a baby? I haven't made a trike saddle either yet. Let's grab our paints just to have. And let's go ahead and stick this like a soup. Let's get the like a soup. And let's head over here and just see really quickly. Can we paint the baby dino? I hope this doesn't like glitch him through the world or something like that. Let's see if we can do this. Oh, we can paint him. We'll paint a little mark right here. And then, like, we will, like, make a birthmark, so to speak. And then see, like, he's got a little painty birthmark on him. I just want to see if that sticks around. I haven't tried to paint a little teeny weeny baby yet. But that's interesting to know. So you can paint the babies as they're growing. Oh, we got a few more minutes. And then we'll BRBs. But they're brand new. Not baby dino, peeps. We're back. It's about to happen. I think. We're very close now. We're very close now. It's only been for several days. It seems like. He's got about the same height. Oh, crap. You know what? I don't have a trike saddle. Why would I need one? I don't have a T-Rex saddle. Are you going to not be an adolescent soon, Y-Tooth? Come on. Become a man. Are you a dude or a lady? Yeah, you're a man. Become a man! He did it! Did you hear him? And he did his little roar! You're a full-grown man now. So what did he get out for stats? Basically the same stuff we saw. Yeah, so these stats didn't change at all, but he's got full stats now. And he's our little man! And his birthmark stayed through the growth stages, which is kind of a little test that I wanted to do. But we've got to get him a saddle now. And we've got to paint him. I have an idea for a paint job. I'm pretty excited about it. We'll see what goes on here. I don't think... I checked back at the Poop City. We don't have any T-Rex blueprints, which kind of blew my mind. And I checked over here, too. I don't have any T-Rex blueprints. So let's go ahead inside of Hyon like a so and look into Rex. And let's learn this bad boy right there. Crafted in the smithy. Let's pop over and see all the stuff and things we need to get this done. Let's get stupid big pigeon. Let's get me up your butt. Thank you. So we can carry some stuff and things here. I can't remember what we need for the T-Rex saddle. We might have all the stuff we need already. All right, let's pop in here. Saddles. No, we don't. So Rex saddle right there. 380 hide, 200 fiber, 50 metal ingots. I'll tell you what, guys. I'm going to go ahead and get the saddle ready. I'm going to paint him. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Hey, guys. Whoa. I'm going to paint him and I'll be RBs. That's right, White Tooth. Give him poop. And we've done it, ladies and gentlemen, peeps. White Tooth has his amazing paint job. And you can see, oh, crap, his lip is all frigged up. Hold on, hold on. We got to unfrig his lip up. We got to unscrew up his lip. All right, hold on. Let's go like this. Oh, wait. No, no. Too close. Back out. There we go. Perfect angle. And there's a little bit on his cheek right here, too. We missed. Let's get his little lip. We need this to be blue. Nailed it, Ace. It can't be stopped. Now we have a two-tone wide tooth. He's absolutely amazing. We on Gamma 2? Oh, there you go. You can see him better now, maybe. Maybe not. And he is absolutely amazing. He is one half of his father Bluetooth. And he is one half of his mother Wi-Fi. He is the most amazing Y-Tooth. Let's get on him. Oh, he's already got a level available. Let's go ahead and pump his weight. Yep, let's go ahead and pump his weight. we're going to take him out now and get some leveling up done on him, peeps. It's time to get some Y-Tooth hunting action happening. Here we go. Let's do it. And we're back. I'm going to go ahead and load up Y-Tooth on the dino transport. I'm pretty sure Zul'jin and Drax made this bad boy, but you guys got to check this out. I showed it off in the little montage there, by the way. I hope you liked it. If you did, make sure you show your support. Hit the thumbs up button if you like the montage stuff and things. I got to zoom way, way out here. Hold on. Check it out. Does this thing look amazing? We're just taking the dino across the river, man. We got to try not to get him too close to D-Max house. I know that, yeah, we don't want him to see the spam of the name of the raft and stuff and things like that. But this raft is pretty unbelievably cool. And it looks cool. I love our guy, Y-Tooth. I got to paint his saddle for sure as well. But yeah, and when we get him over to the edge here, I'll show you what I've done. We went ahead and leveled him up. Actually, I can show you guys right now. Oh, we're getting a little bit of something happening. We did level him up a little bit. He's up now to 173. He's at 840 melee damage. Want to get his melee damage up to 1,000. They maybe pump his health a little bit. But really, one of the things that I want to talk about, because today's been all about kind of dino breeding and those sorts of things. And, you know, the real thing, I think, where the real part of this that's really going to shine is if you had two perfect teams And then instead of having to get another perfect team, you could just make a baby. That's really, like, really cool. And possibly with the potential of that baby having, like, better statistics than the parents, possibly. It's a really interesting theory. I haven't really tested it out very much. This is my first one. I'm sure we'll do a lot more breeding in the future. But for nowsies, this is really interesting to see. You know, I'm thinking about in the future as well, things like, you know, could you breed a super dodo? You know what I mean? Like, what kind of cool stuff is in the future? I don't know. But yeah, that's going to be for today, guys. It has been a long recording session getting this guy up and running for you. But I hope that you liked it. And I hope you had fun. If you guys did, make sure you show your support and hit the thumbs up button. Feel free to share and favorite it as you see fit. May the stuff and things be with you.